What's going on YouTube? It's Donnie B all day. You caught me mid laugh because I was just texting with Scabber Choir Boys outdoors and he was cracking me up. So here's the deal. This is going to sound stupid by title. How to chop wood with a knife. Duh, you go like this. But it's actually not stupid. And then for some people, and this is my own design, the D-Bad Gator Tail, for sale at www.thekukrihouse.com, K-H-U-K-U-R-I house. So yeah, my Gator Tail, stupid awesome knife. Basically, a lot of people say, well, why chop wood with a knife anyway? Why don't you have an axe? And here's the deal. If you are a camper where you like to hike your gear into the woods and set a camp instead of driving your car up to the campsite, getting out and unloading everything at the trunk of your car, so you're parked where you camp, sure, you can do that. It's kind of cheating, but now you can pack more stuff. You can pack your axe, you can pack a chainsaw, you can pack whatever you want and get your business done. But if you are a trekker, a long hauler, minimalism is the way to go. If you're not a minimalist, you're going to be dragging ass halfway down the trail wondering, why did I carry so much stuff? So it's best to have a one option tool. So when it comes to chopping, you're going to need a knife, first of all, that can chop, and second of all, that can chop well. So the reason this video is coming out is because somebody asked me about chopping with a knife, because they said I was chopping and I hurt my wrist, and one person, not in this knife, but on the knife they had, and I won't say what brand it was because I don't want to bash the brand, it could have just been a mishaps, but when they hit, they pulled the knife out and took a nice little chunk boop, 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 out of the blade, and they were pissed. And the reason that happened, and I can guarantee it, is because he didn't hit and lift, he hit and twisted and lifted, which is common because that's what you're doing. You're doing this, you're doing this. As soon as your blade gets stuck, you kind of just go like this. What happens is and he was using a hollow grind knife, right? So with a hollow grind especially, and this is not a hollow grind, this is convex, so it's really, really nice and thick here. But what happens is the hollow goes like this, and it gets really thin the closer to the edge you get. So from here to here would be concave. And therefore, the steel in this area on his knife was super freaking thin. So while it could chop, chopping incorrectly, not so good. So we're going to show you a really basic video, stupid easy, but how to properly chop wood with a knife. Because if the knife is the only thing you have on you, it's got to be your chopper, your everything, poppet opener, your kindling maker, your fire maker, your food stripper, your food cutter, and food eater, everything. That's how I really eat. So it's got to be like a one-all do-all type situation. So let's go and find us a log that we can chop through. Hold on. All right, so this video isn't going to be very long because it shouldn't take a 60-minute tutorial on how to chop. So basically, and especially depending on the kind of knife you want, using an okay grip, like a kukri grip, is pretty much your best way. If you're taking the knife in a full grip, squeezing your hand on it and going like this with your arm and coming down, you're going to, as you can see, you're going to chop no matter what. The problem is you are going to expel a ton of energy. The good thing is, for the most part, you're not going to screw up because you're going up and down. So you can do this all day long. With a kukri grip, it's called the OK grip. You let the blade do part of the work. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to flex from here. And you notice where I'm still getting the same chops, and I'm removing the same amount of material. The difference is I'm not doing this. I'm not going to wear myself out. And if you have to cut, say, to make a shelter, you have to cut enough pieces or to collect firewood, you don't want to be out there all day swinging like Paul Bunyan. You want to be able to get as much as you can. And you'll see, as I go quick, you can't really tell, but what's happening is I'm opening, closing. So these two stay pinched the whole time. I'm pulling the blade forward. So I'm just going to, you know, you can't see it there, but I'm just going to pull the blade. You see how it gets stuck in there? Pull the blade. Pull the blade. Pull the blade. Now, the key is to keep these two locked because you don't really want it spinning. But another thing is when people hit and they hit at an angle with a full grip, that's where twisting comes in. That's why the guy hurt his wrist from chopping, because he was getting twists inside the wrist. This way, no twisting. So the reason the blade broke is because when he hit, the blade got stuck and then he went like this, which is common, which you're going to do. On a knife like this, I wouldn't have to worry about that breaking, but it's still a practice that you should get into of not twisting the knife. If your blade gets stuck like that, instead of twisting, lift up on the heel and then try and pull. If it's stuck in there and you lift up on the heel and it's still stuck, push down on the heel. So just kind of wiggle it, but you want to wiggle it dead, wiggle it just a little bit. You want to stay straight. So if you go in at an angle and it's wedged in, that means your straight is here, right? Not here. So I'm not going to lift it up. I'm going to lift it out. So when you're chopping, first of all, to avoid tiring yourself out. So here I am, I'm stuck in the wood. To avoid tiring myself out, I'm going to use the okay grip. Now I'm stuck and I'm at an angle. If I pull up and I have a weak blade or a bad blade, not only can I possibly chip it, but I could warp it, anything like that. Even a nice thick edge like this one, you do something wrong, you could damage it, right? It's user error in that sense. So I could twist and pull, and right now I'm pushing on the knife. You hear that? That means I was really wedged in there. I didn't damage this one because it's a big, thick, fat-ass, nice beast. But on a blade where if I was going like that and then I just ripped it, I can cause some damage. That I was going nice and slow on that one. But so from here, right, I'm stuck inside this tree. I can see that my angle is this way. What I'm going to do is press down straight, not at an angle, not twisting it, but straight. So here I am. Now I'm going to lift up straight, push down. My knife is out. And the thing is, you don't want, when you're doing it, nature takes over up, you know, and you're like, oh, I got stuck, but you're hammering constantly. So you're not pausing because your body's already thinking about the next strike, but you have to train yourself to, once it gets stuck, lift it straight out. So when you're striking, try to keep all your hits flexed. That way because I'm opening my hand and closing my hand, it naturally will pause if it gets stuck. Doing this, I might not pause. Nature might not take over, or nature will take over, and I'm just going to keep on swinging through. If it gets stuck, I'm not going to be able to stop myself. But here, I'm able to just absolutely press pause on life if it gets stuck, and then say, oh, okay, now I know I need to press it out. I know it sounds stupid. I know it seems like something you should be doing already, or you already know. And just so you see, this thing chops like a mother. But it will absolutely save you. It'll save you. It'll save your knife edge. It'll save you a whole lot of tiresome action just doing that. So that, my friends, is how you chop a log or chop wood using a knife. Pretty freaking simple, right? That's it. All right. For all my campers, hunters, hikers, enjoy the world. I am Donnie B. All Day. Till next video.